We've all been there. You're sitting in traffic one day, and as you look over, you spot a driver two knuckles deep in his nose. He's so busy mining for gold that he doesn't realize that everyone around him can see him. Or maybe he just doesn't care. You watch as he roots around, and then predictably, he finally unearths his find. A nice, fat, golden nose oyster. Then to your horror, you watch him pop it into his mouth and swallow it in one go with a satisfied sigh. Then he's back at it again, angling for more delicious nose clams deep in his own skull. Hello and welcome to another episode of the Infographics Show. Today we're going to tell you why, despite the temptation, you should never ever eat your boogers. According to statistics that we just made up, 3 out of every 7 Americans regularly pick their own nose and then eat their boogers. At least that's what it seems like to us as we're sitting in traffic and observing our local Earth cohabitants. There's no official statistic because nose picking is unsurprisingly something that isn't very well studied by scientists. Booger eating is even less studied, as scientists can't find enough willing volunteers to form the basis of a credible study. We'd like to think that that's because there's just not enough booger eaters, but in all likelihood, it's simply because they are probably too embarrassed to admit to the habit. But other than being a disgusting thing for others to see you do, what are the actual risks or possible benefits to booger eating? First though, we have to explain boogers themselves. What is snot exactly? Mucus is a slimy, water-based bodily fluid that your body produces in order to help protect itself. It turns out that snot is actually pretty important, and is typically your front line of defense against infection. That's because snot helps trap dust and other particles that you accidentally inhale, which very often includes viruses, bacteria, and fungus spores. As the would-be invaders catch a ride on air currents, they enter your nose and throat and more often than not get trapped in the sticky mucus that lines the walls of our respiratory system. Mucus, however, also helps to moisten the air that you inhale in, which makes it easier for you to breathe. If you've ever been severely dehydrated, you know that breathing can actually feel quite uncomfortable, which makes you thankful for snot in your normal day-to-day life. So knowing that boogers help trap harmful bacteria, viruses, and other nasty things that are best kept out of your body rather than in, we bet some of you can make a pretty strong argument already for why we should in fact eat at least some of our own boogers. We're willing to bet you're in fact already prolific booger eaters, but hey, it's your body and we can't tell you what to do or not to do with it, unfortunately. Back to our point though, some booger aficionados claim that eating our boogers is actually beneficial to our health, as it ingests some of the bad bacteria and viruses that the body would normally keep out, and thus forces the body to fight off a much smaller infection. These people typically base their rationale on the way that vaccines work, which, by the way, they do work, and you should never ever take medical advice from Jenny McCarthy. In a vaccine, a deactivated form of a pathogen is injected into the body, and while the pathogen is unable to actually cause infection, it prompts an immune system response, which teaches the body how to fight this infection off. Then, when the real pathogen comes around ready to kick the door down and make your body its property, your immune system already knows how to respond and has the proper antibodies prepared to shut it down quickly. Eating your own booger should work much in the same way, thus proving to be a health benefit instead of a health risk, right? Well, no, because that's just not how biology works. See, when you eat your boogers, you're not inserting them into the bloodstream directly, but rather into your stomach, and most of what ends up there gets destroyed by strong stomach acids long before it gets absorbed into the body. So you're not actually boosting your immune system, you're just trying to cover up your nose clam habit. But if your boogers just get destroyed in the stomach acid, then what's the big deal? How could it possibly be dangerous just to eat them? The answer to that question comes from 2 different potential points of entry for infection that are facilitated when you pick your nose and then eat your boogers. First, the act of picking the nose itself can often scratch up the inside of your nose, which leaves openings for all the germs your boogers are trying to keep out of your body to happily migrate into your body. More to the point, you're also placing yourself at risk with bacteria that you normally wouldn't breathe in, such as staph bacteria that live under your disgusting fingernails. Don't even pretend that you've cleaned your nails anytime in the last 3 weeks, because you haven't. At best, you've given your hands a cursory washing. Staph bacteria is actually pretty common under people's fingernails, along with fecal matter and a host of other fun stuff. When you pick your nose, you're giving all that nastiness a free ride directly inside your body, which is why we recommend you never pick your nose, or you cut all your fingers off, because if you don't, the bacteria will get you. It's pretty rare, but one 53-year-old woman managed to carve a hole right through her sinus with her constant nose picking. While the damage was discovered and repaired in time, holes in your sinus are a pretty serious threat and can make it possible for the bacteria living in your nose right now to make their way straight to your brain. For some people, you'd hardly notice, but for the rest of us, brain infections are very serious business that can lead to brain damage or even death. The other way that germs can find their way inside you by eating your boogers is by hitching a ride in the mucus that you roll up into a tight little ball before you chuck it down your throat. The odds are low, but it is possible that protected by the mucus, bacteria could make their way past your stomach acid and into your intestinal tract, where it would be free to start setting up shop. So let's say that you're addicted to eating delicious nose clams and that you can't seem to stop picking your nose. What can you do to help stop or at least limit how much nose picking you do? Number 1. Identify underlying causes. If you always have an itchy or runny nose, then seasonal allergies could be to blame. Over-the-counter medications such as Claritin or Zyrtec can help with the symptoms of allergies, as can simple anti-congestion medications such as cough syrup, which will go a long way towards drying up the fields and fields of slimy nose oysters waiting to be harvested and eaten. Number 2. Remove your fingers. Scientific studies have proven that fingers are the number one tool used for nose picking, and our Infographics medical staff recommends removing them so as to prevent you from picking your nose. No fingers, no nose picking. It's not exactly an elegant solution, but we dare you to argue that it wouldn't work. Number 3. Use saline nose drops or humidifiers. Using drops or humidifiers can keep your boogers from drying out and thus becoming hardened. Admittedly, it's when boogers are nice and crunchy that they're the funnest to pick, and keeping them nice and humid will prevent them from getting that way. Number 4. Tracheotomy. If you get yourself a tracheotomy and then proceed to plug up your nasal cavity, you'll no longer have a need for the upper respiratory system. With your nostrils permanently plugged up, we recommend a humid environment contact cement, you'll no longer be able to shove your fingers into your nose to mine for gold. The plus side of a tracheotomy is that you can get a voice box and sound like a cool space robot. Number 5. Use a memory device to help reduce subconscious nose picking. It's no accident that nose picking activities reach their zenith during rush hour traffic, as most people resort to nose picking while bored. Using a memory device can alert you to this subconscious time waster, and you can wrap a small bandage around your lead nose picker so that the moment you see it approach your face, you realize you shouldn't be picking your nose. Number 6. Gather the Avengers, defeat Thanos, wield the Infinity Gauntlet, and use its power to wish yourself to never pick your nose again. Top medical experts agree this is the best way to end a troublesome nose-picking habit. So now that you know better, do you still plan on snacking on some all-organic nose oysters? Check out our other video, What Happens If You Only Drink Soda and Nothing Else. And as always, if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more great and highly relevant content.